Good morning, everyone. We are outside HMP Style in Wilmslow, Cheshire. It is Thursday, the 10th of January. I am here to tell everyone about Melanie Shaw. Melanie Louise Shaw. Melanie may or may not be in Style Prison. We are not actually allowed to know where she is. After a tragic childhood where Melanie was sexually interfered with over 100 children at the now infamous Beechwood Children's Home, Melanie took to walking the streets of Nottingham, telling people about the Westminster paedophiles who interfered with children at Beechwood. Mrs. Theresa May, as Home Secretary, got to hear about this and was not pleased. It was obvious that what Melanie Shaw knew about Westminster paedophiles would bring down the British government. Mrs. Theresa May, as Home Secretary, ordered Melanie to go to a secret trial, where Melanie was sentenced to 2 years in prison. We know what the sentence was, but we do not know what the charges were or what the verdict was. That's why the trial was done in secret, so that nobody would know what was happening to Melanie Shaw behind closed doors. Melanie was first sent to HMP Foston Hall in Derby. She was then transferred to Eastwood Park Women's Prison in Gloucestershire, and finally to Style Prison, where we are at the moment. Melanie has written me 11 letters from Style since September of last year. She has written to me about absolute cruelty, going to the toilet and having three officers watching as she went to the toilet, also having two showers a week and being seen by three prison officers, one of whom was a man. Melanie also told me about lack of food, lack of water, and lack of prescribed medication. Melanie's letters to me stopped on the 10th of May. Melanie's release date was the 2nd of June. That is when the 2 years were up. But did anyone really think that Melanie would be released after 2 years? Of course not. Mrs. May is far too frightened of what Melanie Shaw can tell you about Westminster and Nottingham paedophiles. A series of bogus Crown Court trials at Leeds Crown Court were cooked up, and Melanie was made to attend two of them. At the first that Melanie attended, she was said to be confused and not knowing quite where she was. At the second, a few months ago, the judge said that Melanie was rambling and incoherent, and it is felt that Melanie had been forcibly drugged in order to give the impression that she was very mentally ill. This tie in with the fact that I have not had a letter from Melanie since the 10th of May last year, and no one else seems to have had a letter after that date either. If they have, I haven't been told about it. Let me come up to present day. Mrs. May is determined that Melanie will be sectioned and sent to Rampton. And here I have to bring in a forensic psychiatrist called Mr. Leo McSweeney. Now, Mr. Leo McSweeney is a forensic psychiatrist at Arnold Lodge Psychiatric Hospital in Leicester and at Rampton High Security Hospital. It has been said that Mr. Leo McSweeney has been told he must find Melanie a danger to society, section her, and have her removed to Rampton Hospital, where it is feared she will never come out. Melanie's sentencing trial is on Monday, the 14th of January in the morning. And I fear that after that date, Melanie will never be seen again. The truth of it is, we don't even know that today Melanie is actually here at Stile Prison, because the government does not want you to know where Melanie is. Melanie, if you're listening, I promise you, very many people are doing as much as they can to help you. There is a poster of you which has gone viral on media months ago. That poster has been seen attached in public all over the United Kingdom and in France, Belgium, Germany, Austria, Spain, Australia, and many parts of the United States of America. We are basically fighting Mrs. Theresa May, who is giving orders to Stile Prison and probably many other prisons. I want to make it absolutely clear that if Mr. Leo McSweeney is not the forensic psychiatrist who has been told he must section Melanie, please would Mr. Leo McSweeney come forward to clarify matters. This is all in the interests of public transparency and clarity. We have a need to know this. Melanie Shaw has written to me that she is being treated worse than an animal. We are definitely fighting Mrs. May and a very corrupt UK government. Ladies and gentlemen, I have to tell you that our fathers, grandfathers, and great-grandfathers did not fight two world wars for us to have to put up with this. They fought for freedom, and freedom of speech is being denied to us all, especially Melanie Shaw. Melanie Shaw is not the only person silenced in prison. It's happened to Jada Franson and Paul Goulding and Tommy Robinson and many, many others. Mrs. May, I am appealing to you that at the moment your name in this country stinks to high heaven. If before now and Monday the 14th of January you can pick up the phone and stop Melanie Shaw being sectioned, people will look up to you as a person of strength, character, and courage. Wouldn't you rather that than have people talk about you the way they do now? Mrs. May, the choice is yours. Melanie, if you're listening, we will never, ever give up the fight to release you. We all love you. And I will end by saying, this is Laura Thomas for Melanie Shaw at Stile Prison, Wilmslow, Cheshire, in the cesspit of a country that I am ashamed to say is the United Kingdom. Good morning.